Hello, and welcome to Masterworks of Video Game Music. I'm your host, Professor Lesser, and today we will be discussing the soundtrack of one of the most influential games of the Nintendo Entertainment System, Mega Man 2. Mega Man 2 was released in the United States in 1988 from the Japanese developer Capcom. The sequel to the original Mega Man, released in Japan as Rockman in 1987, Mega Man 2 continued the innovative gameplay feature of having the player choose the order in which to progress through the stages. Each stage had its own unique theme music and reflected the theme of the robot Bossmaster. Composed by Takashi Tateishi, Mega Man 2 surpassed the expectations set by his predecessor and is now considered one of, if not the, greatest game in the entire series. Tateishi was not, however, the composer of the original Mega Man. That honor belongs to Manami Matsume, who had transferred to the arcade division of Capcom before Mega Man 2 was created. However, Matsume did provide assistance to Tateishi, particularly for the Airman stage and the opening theme, which was intended as a continuation of the ending theme to Mega Man 1. The Mega Man games released on the Nintendo Entertainment System are perfect examples of the height of chiptune music, which was the only type of sound achievable on 8-bit machines like the original Nintendo. The NES's sound capability was comprised of only four channels that could function at the same time. This was made up of two melody channels, a bass line, and a noise channel used for percussion effects. Though that might be considered by today's standards as extremely limited, Matsume, Tateishi, and other Mega Man composers would achieve a lasting and iconic contribution to video game music. Ironically, Tateishi never formally studied music in school. He began learning to play keyboard by participating in a band at middle school. Receiving a position in the music department at Capcom, Tateishi trained under Harumi Fujita, composer of Bionic Commando. After Manami Matsume moved to Capcom's arcade division, Tateishi was asked to compose the score to Mega Man 2 based on Matsume's thematic concepts presented in Mega Man 1. Initially, Tateishi had little success with his first attempts, which were rejected by Akira Kitamura, Mega Man 2's director. Kitamura wanted the game to have a cool rock and roll theme as opposed to Tateishi's music, which was criticized for being too cute. Only one of Tateishi's first attempts, the Crash Man stage, made it into the final game. The rest of the music, including the introduction, the Robot Masters, and the Dr. Wily stage, are all in a minor key. In addition, all of the music is played at an extremely rapid speed with no changes in tempo. This was to accentuate the feeling of energy and action that is part of the game's style. In particular, Quick Man's theme was created with the objective that the player would feel as if they needed to hurry up, as demonstrated in the section of the stage where light beams travel across the stage rapidly that the player must avoid or they would be destroyed in one hit. Most of the melodies were designed to replicate the sound of the electric guitar, except the Bubble Man theme, which is more piano-based. A favorite theme of Kitamura's became what is now known as the Dr. Wily Stage 1 theme. Because it appealed to him so much, Kitamura asked Tateishi to compose a similar theme, which would become the Woodman stage. However, Tateishi's favorite was the ending theme, which is the only theme that is a completely different mood than the rest of Mega Man 2's music. As Mega Man slowly walks away from Dr. Wily's castle, the seasons change while a reflective and even melancholy theme plays, ultimately ending when Mega Man leaves his helmet by a field as his mission is completed. One of the most striking aspects of Tateishi's score is the complete lack of music in the final stage of Dr. Wily's castle. The stage is very short, with Mega Man avoiding pools of lava dripping from the ceiling. The bloops of the drips are the only sound before the final fight with Dr. Wily, and is extremely effective in building tension as the silence is fairly unnerving given all the musical activity in prior stages. Tateishi credited Kitamura for the idea, calling him a creative genius.
Tateishi is acknowledged in the post-game credits as Ogoretsu-kun. He would also later contribute to the music of Mega Man 10, released in 2010, and Mighty No. 9 in 2016. However, it is the soundtrack of Mega Man 2 in which he is most well known, and which has become celebrated as some of the greatest chiptune music of the Nintendo era. Thanks so much for watching, and please comment below as to which game's music you would like to discuss. You can also subscribe to be notified of new videos as well. Until then, I'm Professor Lesser. See you next time.